I will talk about AnyMod, a Julia package for creating energy system models that I have developed. Energy system models are typically linear optimization problems that optimize capacity investment and operation to satisfy energy demand. And the focus of AnyMod is specifically with macro energy systems. That means systems that cover an entire country or an entire continent. And AnyMod is capable of not just modeling a single year, but an entire pathway, for example, from today's energy system to a decarbonized energy system in 2050. Of course, an important part in decarbonization play fluctuating renewables like wind and solar, but they are also difficult to model because they require substantial spatial and especially temporal detail to be represented accurately. And as a result, they can easily lead to model sizes that cannot be solved anymore within reasonable time. And against that background, one specific purpose of AnyMod was to facilitate creating detailed and large models and solving them more easily. AnyMod, the package is implemented in Julia 1.5 and utilizes data frames for data management and of course, Jump as the underlying package for optimization. I've invested great effort to make the tool accessible even for users with little programming skills because in energy system modeling, the use of high-level programming languages is still not standard. And models in AnyMod can be fully defined by CSV files. And also outputs are entirely written to CSV files because everybody knows to use Excel, even if they don't know how to use Julia. And as a result, users can run quite sophisticated models just with running a few lines of standard code in Julia. To make the tool accessible, I've also provided online documentation created with Documenter and added several plotting features that I will also present later in this presentation. The package presents a graph-based modeling approach that I've specifically developed, but that I will not go into detail here because it's more of an energy modeling than a Julia topic. As I said earlier, it does allow for multiple time steps of capacity expansion or pathways. It includes a specific inheritance algorithm for the read-in of parameter data that, for example, allows to dynamically use the same input file with very different models. This is also something I will not have the time to go into detail in, but if you're interested in it, just as the graph-based modeling approach explained in the literature linked in the documentation. Lastly, the package includes automatic scaling of the created optimization problem to keep the parameters and coefficient of the problems in a certain range that makes it more easier to be solved by interior point solvers. For the package to work, it was very important to find a way to create constraints both dynamically, but also very efficiently. And to achieve this, I combined data frames and database style commands with the jump objects to create constraints. How this is achieved is demonstrated here in this slide. So first we have the data frame of generation variables that stores the respective variables in the very right column with the other columns of integers representing the respective dimension for each variable. And we have a demand parameter that is stored in an analogous data frame, but of course here instead we have a value column instead of a variable column. And the energy balance can now be created. And by the way, the energy balance is just a constraint that is enforcing that the generation at each time step and in each region and for each carrier does at least exceed the demand. And it can now be created by aggregating the generation variables by technology, and then perform a join command on the resulting data frame that adds the demand. And then we have all information in one data frame to create the constraint, which results in the data frame on the very bottom. And this example also gives a little bit of an insight how the automatic scaling in AnyMod is achieved. And this is if you look into the generation variables, for example, by substituting and not directly putting the generation variable in the column, but instead an affine expression that also includes the scaling factors for the variables to then later in the final model result in more favorable range of coefficients and factors. The effect of this automatic scaling on solve time is presented here in the next slide. There it is. And it shows that this effect is actually quite drastic. So when we apply automatic scaling, the solve time is about 2 or 3 times smaller. And by the way, this is computed for 2 different ordering algorithms with Gurobi. And if we apply no automatic scaling, the interior point solver, in this case Beria, will always result in numerical trouble, which is why we have to set up the numeric focus to obtain a result, which results again in much longer solve times. In the remainder of the presentation, I will briefly present the plotting tools that I've talked about earlier. So in more sophisticated applications compared to the stylized example earlier, we have a lot of different energy carriers covered in our energy system models and a lot of different technologies, which are represented in the qualitative energy flow graph here, which was created with a package using PyCall and then Python plotting devices. And the package is not limited to this qualitative energy flow graph, but is always also capable of creating the quantitative counterpart, which is the Sankey diagram, which solves which shows the results after solving the model and depicting the actual energy flows that the model will result on. And this is again created with PyCall and Plotly. So come to the conclusion. The package is of course openly available on GitHub. There's a stable version that is thoroughly tested and fully documented, but we are also working constantly on a development version with more additional features. And I guess that's it. And I'm looking forward to your questions.